Hello, Chargeback Army. It's Terence from Chargeback Forward. You're currently watching me eat shit. Probably my least favorite thing about the Resident Evil 2 remake Ghost Survivors mode is the inability to pause and try again when you're seeing this nonsense. I mean, there's only so many times you can watch a horrific dismemberment. Anyways, we're going to do No Time to Mourn with probably my favorite character other than Leon, Robert Kendo. Robert's gone through quite the transformation since the original and has become quite the sympathetic character. All right, let's get into it here. So this is definitely what started to really change how I thought about the Ghost Survivors mode and the strategies that I employ. This is still an earlier playthrough, so certain techniques you are not going to see. And I stress, by no stretch of the imagination, is this a speedrun nor a no damage run. This is me sharing with you the joy that I get from finally being able to pass these challenges. And time for the music to ramp up. Time to get into this commentary. Okay, so as you can see, I weaved through everybody coming to the garage and took out my 9mm and just gave a little bit of a bee sting to that guy's fuel pack. I mean, why are you even wearing that? But I digress. We're gonna hit around this corner here, and you see one guy at the end. There's so many ways of dealing with this dude, including running up to him and shoving your gun in his face. But as you can see right now, I'm more interested in a conservative approach. Get that on the ground, do a quick churn, and of course, I can't shoot for shit, so the first shot misses, but I was able to explode it in time for the liquor. Now this guy coming up here, you can either do the do-si-do, but I just feel like filling people with pellets right now. Alright. So coming into this room, we have three zombies. This dude right here goes in one shot. I'm gonna take your knees out, and I thought I got that guy good, but you know, perpetual motion is a hard thing to stop. And unfortunately, I have already sustained damage. But fear not, as I've learned from the fourth survivor, never give up. Alright, so we're gonna run down this hallway here, and before entering the room, we're gonna take our 9mm out again and give the guy a little shot in the tailbone. So time to do the ever so entertaining combining of resources to get as many shotgun shells as possible. Not really going to be shooting that 9mm too often, just in certain situations. I honestly can't remember if I do it from this point on. Well, I do it at a certain point, but here we go. So coming down this hallway, I find everything is very tightly timed. So once you get going, once this animation has been triggered, you want to be well on your way to run past them. No need to stop, no need to shove lead in anyone's skull. One of the easier parts. But again, if your timing's not right, you'll find yourself in a world of trouble. Okay, flashbang, as you'll see, that's going to be coming very handy later on. And then probably my least favorite zombie model in the game. Not for any lack in design, but just because it's a creepy old dude. And I find for some reason I have the most difficulty dispatching this type of zombie. So over here on the ground, we have several bodies lying in wait. And there are some speed runs where if you can run directly to the elevator, you're able to press the button and maybe even get on the elevator before all of the zombies generate. But that is an invitation to lots of damage and death animations if it's not done perfectly. So this is the method that I prefer to watch and do myself. So I have, of course, have taken care of that guy carrying the fuel canister, and some reason didn't get this guy, so I'm just gonna continue peppering him in his lower back and buttocks region with a couple of shots to his genitals just to round things off. And as I was saying before, I don't really use the 9mm too much in this mode, so I'm not particularly concerned about dumping half a clip into that guy's nether regions. Okay, so let's get going back over to that elevator. And that's kind of funny. I thought I called it when I went over there, but I guess I was too concerned about getting out without getting bit. Okay, down the elevator we go. Do, 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 do. All right, so right after here is a point where you get to choose which direction you want to go. Another reason that No Time to Mourn is my favorite Ghost Survivors game is specifically for this option here. Okay, so I have a feeling that this is going to be us taking care of business here. Shotgun to the skull to handsome Asian scientist. And I'm going to pepper that poisony guy. Get the spark shot. And yep, I decided to turn right on this run. So you can go both ways. One is shorter, one is longer. The shorter one is harder, but that's okay. Okay, so you're going to go over here, press that button. And we got calorically challenged zombie. So clearly there's going to be no problems, even though Robert is not a trim fellow, but all the characters pretty much operate exactly the same. So I see a glowing eye poison zombie, or whatever you want to call him over there. And I'm just going to introduce him to a handful of 9mm rounds. And you know they're dead when they basically aggas you. So over here, I've doing a little bit of a moonwalk because I'm looking to generate. By the roar, G-Adult. As soon as you hear that roar, you want to run right out and get your spark shot ready. Wait a couple seconds. You want to be able to connect with that. And of course, give that a full go. So I've decided this. I'm going to try to creep around him. Successful in that. There have been times where I have been blocked. Okay, this guy can be a problem. You do want to wait. That's probably the earliest you can shoot that guy successfully. So I'm going to give him a little bit of electrical love. Oh, I got hit by one of the G-babies that's been spreaded out. Now, this guy comes around really quick. All I have to do is kind of creep around to the corner and do a quick double back. And the G-adults have been rendered effectively useless. All right, we got a plant guy up here, so vine zombie. I could have done so many things to him, but I'm just like, I'm going to use the spark shot, as it was my last round, and I am going to dump it. Okay, so again, still carrying that early damage, but that's okay. I have noticed in some speedruns that the masters of the speedruns for Resident Evil 2 do prefer to actually get hit, as the running animation is slightly faster when you're injured. So as you can tell here, this is where the beginning of the video started, where I unsuccessfully cleared this door. So a lucky thing about this is this particular situation is the zombies are not going to come outside, so basically it's peppering and finding the right moment. So we have a male and a female zombie, as well as at least one Ivy zombie. Oh, I think there's still two guys. There's probably one, two. I can't even count all the guys there, but I found my great moment. And now it doesn't matter because I've jumped down. No interest. No interest at all. All right, we're going to run over here, and nope, that's for a different Ghost Survivor run. There is a Ivy zombie over here. All I have to do is give it one shot to one of his bulbous sacks, and that'll stun him so he can continue on. There are times where I go look at the menu system, and I'm not even sure what I'm doing. Okay, we got three guys over here. Obviously, that first shot was not successful, but as you can see, my avoidance techniques are improving. And all you really want to do here is you're just clearing a path by taking out kneecaps or causing kind of awkward stumble animations like that by our calorically challenged zombie. There is an adult G right there, and honestly, I have no interest. Over here is a real fun part. We have a ton of zombies, and luckily that G adult right now is not behind us. So what I try to do is with my ammo that I had left, and at this point 14 rounds is pretty good, but I found myself in immediate trouble here, already poisoned, so I'm gonna give myself that. And of course there's where the flash grenade comes in handy that I got earlier, and that's fantastic there. So with this guy coming up here, I'm out of ammo, and through doing that delayed things, got bit in the neck, but luckily I was able to down the zombie ahead of me, which is the whole point of that. So when sharing this particular run through with you, it feels pretty easy, especially considering all of the various times that I did that to get to this point. So, you know, commending Robert. This character was in a bad situation. Wife dead. Daughter infected. Ready to put a gun in his head. But we're going to do a little bit of time travel right now. And go back. Because I said earlier, there is a certain point where you can choose between a left and a right path. So we're just going to make our way back around. And let's do this again. Now this time, exiting this door, the technique remains the same. Handsome Asian man. Unfortunate demise, but he's already a zombie, so I don't feel bad about that. And a couple of shots to the kneecaps gets Backpack gas zombie to drop the spark shot. And just very quickly, going back to Kendo, you know, very, very harrowing experience or circumstance for someone to be in. And had he pulled the trigger of the shotgun that he was putting towards his mouth, definitely would be game over for him. Now, of course, that is what happened in the main story, and that never sat well for me. Obviously, in situations like this, and in current times, one can be a little more sympathetic to the difficult decisions that are made, and, you know, you honestly want the best for people. So that's what I'm doing right now, is I'm trying to do the best for Robert by shooting multiple zombies in the skull. Now, I decided to let the zombies come to me there. I found fighting them on the staircase or going down there was a little problematic. So now I only have two to deal with, so bye-bye for your skull. And then sometimes I just don't understand what I'm shooting at. And then here I'm shooting in the dark, and let's count the amount of times I hit that concrete barrier behind that zombie before I'm able to down them. And at that point, he's still trying to get up. And he's still not dead, but, you know, at a certain point, you have to say, I need ammo. So I'm just going to go and grab what is in his backpack so I can continue on the left journey. Alright, obviously I'm deep in thought in this moment here. I'm going to dump the spark shot, as I currently don't have any ammunition for it. And we'll just take that gunpowder just in case. Okay, so now we're going to jump into the sewers. Probably the most tedious, frustrating, yet best part of the campaign, aside from the police station. Now, I was kind of bummed out getting grabbed like that. I thought I had my deacon time, but no, I'm just going to be vomited upon by disgusting poison. And then there's this guy coming out of nowhere. So as you can tell, I'm in pretty bad shape right now. I am poisoned. Was done before the first one you saw. So at this point, I've already given up in my mind, but I'm thinking, hey, if I can get a couple of the Mr. Raccoons, at least this run will not be for naught. So I've decided to cure my poison and see if I can get out. The will to survive sometimes overcomes the will to give up. And that's definitely something that we should develop for all situations, not just playing the video. Okay, so again, at this point, my dodging technique is garbage. And it's time for more vomit again. And then we have this zombie guy. I mean, come on, dude. This guy, I don't see him until after I'm grabbed and he's magically there. Like, the G-Adult is literally shitting him out. So again, I've used my last blue herb, so in bad shape, as you can see. And the worst thing about being poisoned, of course, is occasionally your character will just stop and cough, making it right there, making it impossible to shoot during that time period, and that leaves you very, very, very vulnerable. Okay, so luckily there was a mixed herb with blue, so I can get myself out of the poison status again. Now at this point, unfortunately, I got a little lost and thought I had to go this way. Which, to the astute viewer, will remember, this is exactly where I just came from. So I guess all I've really done at this point is I've dragged my adversaries down a pinch point, which of course is going to make it more difficult, and now here I am going, hey, I've played Resident Evil a few times. I know the layout. Oh, I gotta go that way. So back in I go. We got Zombie. I'm gonna finally take care of that guy, at least enough to get by him. And then we have the G-Adults ejaculating G-Babies. Not interested? Thanks for coming up. Okay, after that detour, we're getting back on track. So initially, guys, I was going to release the Time to Mourn both directions as separate videos, but as you can tell here, am I taking my time, and I'm actually just capturing the video on the PlayStation 4, and it captures in 15-minute intervals. So when I went to look at this footage, I saw where I started off from, and I knew that I couldn't, in good conscience, present this to you guys, and that's why I chose the right-left point as to where to resume this particular footage. Okay, so now we're dealing with another pinch point. We have a lot of gassy zombies, and of course, I could not make a shot that would prevent me from getting poisoned again. So still trying to clear things out, getting a little concerned that my shotgun headshots are not doing what needs to be done, so out goes the 9mm to take care of that guy's gas backpack. I still don't understand that. And then here I am, just dry firing endlessly. How did this guy not die to that explosion? I don't know. Okay, so we're getting a little tighter on resources, and again, poisoned. And no blue herb for me, so it's just time to combine some yellow high-grade gunpowder, as well as the regular, to give me more shotgun shells. More combining. Isn't that nice and tidy? Okay, got that one. Let's continue on. Around the corner here, we have an IV zombie. And because of what's in front of me, and because of the fact that I am poisoned, giving him a quick shot in one of his bulbous sacs and running was not an option, so I kind of had to take care of him in a more permanent fashion. Going up the stairs here, we have a handful of zombies. I'm okay right now for shotgun shells, but as you can see, I'm pretty much done with the 9mm, and I just don't want to waste it. Let's see if we can get people's skulls off again. Not too lucky. Getting some to fall, though. That's pretty good. And then this guy here, I think, is going to give me some trouble because of my coughing. And so I shot him in the skull, but since he was making his way down the stairs, that didn't happen. And I really want that knife back, so I think I spent some shells addressing the matter. Because not having a defense item, especially in scenarios with the G adults, is very problematic. So again, this is my an earlier run through this, so I'm a little loopy with my direction, but as you can tell, can't really get too much off course. Got a couple of guys going here. There goes your ankle, and I did the same thing to that guy. Easy peasy. All right, so I am in desperation mode here. As you see, I'm reloading one shell to my shotgun and then going over just in case. Obviously, the safes, the deposit boxes, anything that you would experience in the regular game is not really active, but I am desperate for some kind of blue herb, and I saw this guy over here, so I made the journey, and I'm pretty happy about that. Well, we got a mixed herb, but unfortunately no blue. So I'm just going to take that remaining powder, clean up my inventory a little bit. And I've already taken the health. Not sure if that was a good idea, but when you're poisoned, you don't really have access to how you're doing health-wise. And I do have that skull and crossbone meter down there. I've never, in all of my experiences playing this game, campaign and otherwise, have been in a situation where that meter on the bottom right with the skull and crossbones depleted to zero. So I'm not sure how effective taking that mixed herb was, but it was a red and green, so if I was at least put back up to full power. Again, just looking to get by these guys. Still poisoned, which is pretty deadly right now. So pretty good string of just knocking out kneecaps and passing by. And now our paths converge, and we're back. And there's Ivy Zombie over there. But this is the one that we're going to deal with. Still poisoned, still shitty. So again, Baldus Sack takes a hit from the Winchester 870. You're not fooling me at all. That's hilarious. I said Winchester because it's a W870, but I do believe Remington makes the 870. Okay, again, we're trying to take out kneecaps. Now, that guy had enough time to get up, but he's gone for a bit of a toss and got that guy taken care of as well. Still poisoned. I'm in dire straits right now. No blue herb, but we are coming to the end. So I decided, as always, push through. If you die, you die. You just have to deal with a grotesque death animation that you cannot skip. So most of the time, I just hit the PS button and wait. All right, so we're going to try to take out people's knees, trying to get a clear path for us. And unfortunately, I did use the flash grenade, so I can't get through these zombies as easy as I'd like to. So as you can tell right now, I just muscled my way through. You know, who knows how close I am to death, being bitten, zombies all around me. But sometimes if you just push through, you can get a square peg through a round hole. So just like that, the left scenario is over. Congratulations, Robert. This is the ending I want for you. I am sorry for your loss, but you were able to get out, which is good. So guys, thank you very much for sharing that with me. Just like that, it is done. Terence from Chargeback Forward. Take care of yourselves, guys. I'll have another video for you very soon.